Congratulations. You have selected a world-class serger from Jaguar, makers of superior sewing machines for nearly half a century. Though our name may be new to you, we've been manufacturing high-quality sergers for some time. Sergers that have been rated number one by a leading consumer magazine. Fact is, Jaguar was the first to introduce home-use zigzag sewing machines in Japan. And since then, we've continued to develop innovative machines based on strict user demands. Today, we're proud to say that we've produced over 10 million machines. Now that you're familiar with our company, let us familiarize you with our products. This video will provide you with a general operation overview of Jaguar serger models 056DW and 055D. With the exception of the 056DW's cutter feature and its two-thread conversion capability, the two machines are identical. Although this presentation features the 056DW, please keep in mind that this video is designed to be representative of both models. You'll notice that during the demonstration section, we've included a series of icons positioned on your screen. These are designed to help you identify each category. This video will cover different threading options and a variety of techniques that accompany them, starting with the category threading, followed by four-thread serging, featuring the four-thread overlock and differential feed control, then three-thread serging, featuring the three-thread overlock, the three-thread flatlock, the three-thread narrow hem, and the rolled hem pico stitch, and decorative stitches, featuring the corded overlock, the pin tuck, and the decorative braid, and finally, two-thread serging using model 056DW, featuring the two-thread rolled hem and the two-thread overlock. Your Jaguar Epochlock comes with all the accessories you'll need, such as a pin cushion, extra needles, a screwdriver, a dust brush, and more. There are a few things to keep in mind when operating your serger. Always position the machine on a flat surface and use a new needle for every new garment. You can use either domestic type spools or cone spools, but use only those of high quality. Refer to your instruction manual for more in-depth information regarding your machine. Use spool caps for domestic type spools and spool holders for cone spools. Use included netting for especially slippery rayon threads. After sewing, clean dust and lint out with the brush provided and apply a few drops of oil. See your instruction manual for further details on maintenance procedures. You'll notice that because the cutter unit can be opened, threading is made easy. First, slide the front cover to the right and pull down. Now, open the cutter unit by pulling the release lever toward you and lifting up the front presser foot. Other elements add to the Jaguar's operating ease. For pin tucking, decorative braids, and other cases where you want to sew without cutting, the moving cutter may easily be disengaged. Simply push the cutter release knob to the left and turn it toward you. Be sure that the fabric's edge is not wider than the over-edge stitch width selected, or the upper looper and needle may be damaged. The presser foot lever is designed for ease in placing and removing fabrics. A foot pressure regulator, factory adjusted for normal sewing, may easily be adjusted to increase or decrease pressure. The easy-to-use stitch length dial can adjust stitch lengths from 1 to 5 millimeters. The differential feed control dial can also be easily adjusted. Our tension control dials are located at the face of your machine. You'll find that they perform significantly better than those found on other machines. Depending on the type of fabric used, the thread tension may need to be adjusted. See page 15 of your instruction manual for a setting chart. This chart is designed as a general tension guide. Fine-tune our recommendations as you see fit. Turning the tension dial to a higher number results in a higher thread tension. A lower number results in a looser thread tension. Then there's our over-edge cutting dial. Over-edge cutting width can be adjusted from 4 to 7 millimeters by simply turning the over-edge cutting width dial. A standard width of 6 millimeters is preset upon delivery. Another feature of our machine is the feed dog. As you can see, ours is longer than that of conventional machines. This results in smoother fabric feeding and excellent stitch performance. Also included is a tightening screw. When sewing extra heavy weight or layers of fabric, tighten the screw. A detachable lint tray is included to help keep your machine clean for maximum performance. The thread cutter, available only with model 056DW, is built into the needle plate. Thread can easily be trimmed near the end of the fabric by pushing down the lever. Model 056DW's converter enables you to convert to two-thread operation and to four-thread operation. Simply open the front cover and the working table. Now raise the needle to its highest point by turning the hand wheel toward you. Pull out the converter and attach it onto the upper looper. Be sure that the converter is securely in place. Remove either the left needle or right needle, depending on your project. Removed needle should be placed on the needle pad inside the front cover so as not to be misplaced. A converter diagram is included on the 056DW for easy reference. Each time you operate your Jaguar serger, fully extend the thread guide and make sure that threads are not caught under the spool holders. You'll find that threading with your Jaguar serger is easier than with conventional machines, as the front cover and the swing-away cutting unit open. For easy reference, a color-coded threading diagram coinciding with looper and needle thread color schemes is included on the inner panel of the front cover. Threading your machine must be in the sequence of lower looper, upper looper, needle, or needles. Refer to your manual for complete details. Raise the needle to its highest point by turning the hand wheel toward you. First, we'll thread the lower looper. As you can see, each of the top thread guides has a right and a left groove. When using regular or thin threads, bring the thread through the right groove and then up and over through the left groove. Bring the thread to the right of the tension dial and wrap the thread around the dial, making sure to catch the hook. Next, feed the thread through the four guides and pass the thread through the eye of the lower looper. Leave about 4 inches of extra thread. To thread the upper looper, thread the top thread guide and pass the thread through the tension guide, as you did when threading the lower looper. Feed the thread through the thread guides and the wire thread guide, and then pass it through the eye of the upper looper. Leave about 4 inches of extra thread. Jaguar makes threading needles easy too. To thread needles, thread the top thread guide and pass the thread through the tension guide, as you did when threading the upper and lower loopers. Draw the thread through the thread guides, thread the needles from front to back through the needle eye, and pull the thread toward the back, passing along the right side of the presser foot. Leave an extra 4 inches of thread. Incorrect threading can result in skipped stitches, broken threads, and other problems. Refer to your instruction manual for detailed diagrams on proper threading, as well as information on the threading of thicker threads. An optional needle hole threader increases ease in threading. To ensure proper threading and to clear all threads, test sew on a small piece of fabric before you begin. Four-thread sewing is best suited for standard serging on woven or knit fabrics. When performing the four-thread overlock on an average weight fabric, set tensions at 4, over-edge width at 6 millimeters, and the differential feed dial to 1. The fabric thickness will determine the exact setting. Refer to your instruction manual for additional information. Here we have the 2.5 millimeter stitch length. Remember, thinner fabrics require shorter stitches, heavier fabrics require longer stitches. Your Epochlock features a differential feed control. It is designed to minimize puckering and wavering and is effective for gathering. Puckering tends to occur on woven or sheer fabrics. To obtain pucker-free seams, set the differential feed control dial at less than 1. Wavering tends to occur on knitted or stretchable fabrics. To obtain waver-free seams, set the differential feed control dial at more than one. Differential feed makes gathering easier on lightweight fabric. Use it on waistlines, sleeve heads, sleeve bottoms, and ruffles. Set the differential feed control dial between 1.5 and 2. For best results, use the optional gathering foot. Your instruction manual provides further details on this feature. Use three-thread serging for knits, seam finishes, flat locking, and lace applications. Either the left or right needle will need to be removed. To remove needles, raise the needle bar to its highest point by turning the hand wheel toward you. Leave the presser foot down, loosen the clamp screw, and remove either needle, depending on your project. For the three-thread overlock, all controls may remain as they were during the four-thread overlock, with the obvious absence of one needle and its corresponding thread. As always, remember to clear the threads and sew a test sample. A three-thread flat lock may be sewn using either the right or left needle. The three-thread flat lock is designed for applying lace on lingerie, applying ribbing, and joining swimwear seams. Sew along the folded edges of fabric, allowing the stitches to hang off the edge. Pull the fabric edge flat when done. Refer to your instruction manual for complete details and settings. Your machine also features a stitch finger, located inside the cutting unit. Remove the stitch finger when performing a narrow hem, a rolled hem, or a picot stitch. Do so by opening the front cover and the cutting unit. Remove the stitch finger from the needle plate, use a screwdriver if necessary, and store it in the front cover. As you can see, beautiful hems on knit fabrics can be obtained with the three-thread narrow hem. Simply set the tensions according to the fabric and thread used and the over edge width to 4 millimeters. Set the stitch length control dial to 2 to 2.5. For best results, use the optional blind hem foot. Create wonderful pieces, like those shown here, with the three-thread rolled hem and picot stitch. It's ideal for rolled hem napkins, sewing on lace, and making family heirlooms. Both a rolled hem and picot stitch require three threads. Woolly nylon thread is recommended. In both cases, set the lower and upper looper thread tensions and the right needle thread tension to 4. The over edge width should be 4 to 6 millimeters. Use your imagination to create projects with varying thread thicknesses and materials. The corded overlock can be used to strengthen shoulders, sleeves, or side seams when joining or sewing bulky or slippery fabrics and knitted garments. As a decorative feature, you can use knitting yarns. Contrasting colors can further enhance your garment. Snap the detachable cord guide onto the thread guide pole. Place a filler cord, such as wool, yarn, 1/4 inch twill tape, etc., at the rear of the machine spool pin. Pass the cord through the cord guides. Insert the cord through either the front or rear hole in the presser foot and pass it under and to the rear of the foot. Place the material to be sewn as usual. Start slowly to be sure that the cord is feeding correctly and increase speed as needed. For pin tucking, often using either a narrow three-thread overlock or a rolled edge, fold the fabric along a line to be pin tucked and overlock sew along the folded edge, making sure not to cut into the folded edge of the fabric. Pull the ends of the thread to the underside and press. For decorative effects, use rayon or metallic threads. Use your imagination. With your Jaguar serger, you can create a wide variety of decorative trims and cords by changing threads, colors, and more. To sew a decorative braid, using 3 threads, overlock over a cord or braid. Hold it carefully with both hands, making sure not to cut the edge. Two-thread serging capability is included with Jaguar's Epochlock model 056DW. For two-thread serging, remove the upper looper thread and attach the two-thread converter. Remember, the stitch finger must be removed. For a demonstration of how to attach the two-thread converter, review the features section. For a two-thread rolled hem, set the lower looper thread tension to 1 or more and the right needle thread tension to any number to 5. Set the overedge width to 4 to 6 millimeters and the stitch length control to 1 to 2. Two-thread overlocking is ideal for seam finishes. For the two-thread overlock, install the left needle, remove the right needle, attach the stitch finger and the two-thread converter. Set the lower looper thread tension to 4 and the left needle thread tension to 0 or more. Set the stitch length control dial to 2.5 to 3.5 and the overedge width to 6 millimeters. A variety of optional feet are available for your Jaguar serger machine. To change presser feet, be sure the needle is in the up position and raise the presser foot lever. Push the release lever. Now place the new foot on the needle plate, aligning the holes. Snap the foot holder into place. Best on knits, our blind hem foot comes in 2 sizes, 0.5 millimeters for fine to medium fabrics and 1 millimeter for medium to heavy fabrics.